guys, it's Kayla and welcome back to my channel. So today's video, I'm going to be talking about the books that I read in January. So in January, I participated in the Once Upon a Grimm Readathon. I was a co-host for the Team Cinderella and I had so much fun with this readathon. It was great to have that feeling of going back into my childhood with fairy tales and all the like happy ending stuff, and I really enjoyed being able to participate in a classic fairy tale readathon. It was really good. So in January I read a total of 5 books. 2 of those were actually on my TBR and the other 3 were not. I did have a couple of others that I read in January, but I'm not going to count them as part of my Goodreads challenge. I'll mention them anyway, but I'm not going to count them as part of my challenge. So 2 of the books that I read were physical, 2 of them were ebook, and 1 of them was an audiobook. So the first one that I read was Hollowpox by Jessica Townsend. This is the 3rd installment in the Nevermore series, and I absolutely freaking love this series. It is so much fun. The world is amazing. I have spoken about this quite a lot because it was only last year that I started reading this series, and the 3rd book came out in October last year, and I finally got around to reading it, and I'm so glad I did. So Nevermore follows a young girl who has been cursed to die when she's 11 years old, but then she gets whisked away to the land of Nevermore, where there is a whole lot of crazy stuff happening. There's a lot of adventure, there's a lot of whimsy, and so many amazing, fantastic characters that I absolutely adore, including Jupiter North, who is like essentially the Matt Smith Doctor Who. I absolutely adore him. This 3rd book ends up following a story that I see is very similar to Zootopia, and I absolutely love Zootopia. So in this one, we follow what happens to be like an outbreak of a virus that only affects wanimals, and wanimals are these animals that have human personalities, which again is like Zootopia, how the animals in Zootopia are all like normal people. But once infected with the virus, these wanimals go crazy, and it ends up being that they get shunned and feared by the rest of society because of these attacks and because of how they are acting, which again is like Zootopia. And I really enjoyed this. It was a really great concept. The story was, again, fantastic. I love this world. I love the characters. It is honestly like a combination of Alice in Wonderland and Harry Potter, but 10 times better, and I love it. I loved being back in this world. I ended up giving this one 4 stars. I think I've given each book 4 stars. I don't know which one is my favorite. I think this one is probably bordering along being my favorite, just because I love the idea of the virus, which sounds really bad considering we're still going through COVID, but you know. But I did really enjoy this, gave it 4 stars. The next book that I read in January was one that I was really, really surprised by because I didn't expect to love it as much as I did, and that was Stepsister by Jennifer Donnelly. This was for the group book. So for Team Cinderella, this was the group book. This was honestly so much better than I had expected, because I found that lately, if I've been reading retellings, especially YA retellings, they don't quite hit the mark. They always end up being, I always end up being let down by them. So that was the case with like Sea Witch. I was so excited for that and got so let down because I had such high expectations for it. The same with Cruel Beauty, which was a retelling of Beauty and the Beast. I was let down by that. There's been so many in the past that I've picked up and I have super high expectations for that I just keep getting let down. So I didn't have high expectations for this going in, and I think that definitely helped. But this follows, it's kind of like a retelling of Cinderella. It's like after Cinderella has had has tried on the slipper, and then she gets married, and this is like the aftermath of what happens after that. And we follow the 2 stepsisters and the stepmother, and the stepmother has gone kind of crazy. She's not all there. And then you have the 2 stepsisters who are trying to rebuild their lives because everybody in their village hates them. They are looked down upon because of how they treated Cinderella. So we follow one of the stepsisters, Isabel. We follow Isabel and we follow her story and how she has always hated herself, and she's completely envious of Cinderella because she sees that Cinderella is this natural beauty who doesn't have to try so hard, and she wishes that she could be pretty. She wants to be beautiful because she thinks that beauty equates to being loved by everybody and being able to succeed in everything in your life. So she's envious of that, and she's trying so hard to be a good person, but nothing is working for her. So we're not just following Isabel, we're actually also meeting these other characters, Fate and Chance. So Fate, I kind of see as like the Fates from Greek mythology, because they're planning out lives and they have all these maps of everybody's lives, and they have a map of Isabel's life and her fate, which is apparently a very dreadful fate, and they know that they can't stop it because it's fate. But then Chance comes in and he steals the map. He says to Fate that he can change it and he can change what her life is supposed to turn out like, and then Fate's like, no, you won't do that. That's impossible. You can't beat Fate. So they sort of have like a little competition where Fate is trying to keep Isabel on the path that she's on, whereas Chance is trying to give her the opportunity to change her fate, to change her future. So we're following the stepsister and the stepmother, their family's lives, trying to get back on their feet and trying to make their lives better and have people see them as better people. They're trying to make their lives better and trying to do things that they want to do. And then we have Fate and Chance trying to do their own thing. There's also this massive war that's going on as well in their kingdom, and it's just so different to what I expected. And I honestly really enjoyed the writing. I enjoyed all the characters. It turned out so much better than I had expected it would. So I really enjoyed this, and I highly recommend it if you are a Cinderella fan like myself. I gave this one 4 stars as well. So the next books that I read, I ended up doing my own little readathon type thing over a couple of days. So I had a couple of days off, and I thought it would be a good opportunity to do a reading vlog where I read a bunch of different Cinderella stories. So I ended up reading the Brothers Grimm version of Cinderella, as well as the Charles Perrault version of Cinderella. I'll link my reading vlog down below so you can see my actual thoughts as I was reading all of these books. But I ended up loving Brothers Grimm one, which I sort of kind of expected because I've always liked the Brothers Grimm stories. But I loved this version better than the Charles Perrault version. But I really enjoyed reading those. Then I read two other like Cinderella type stories. The first one was Hashtag The Real Cinderella by Yesenia Vargas. I think that's how you pronounce the name. And this was like a light sort of contemporary retelling of Cinderella. It very much reminded me of Cinderella's story. There were so many events that I was like, yep, this is just like how the movie played out. And I still enjoyed it. It was really good. It was very simple. It wasn't too like amazing, but it was an entertaining read nonetheless. So this one is about a girl named Ella who lives with her stepmother and her stepsisters naturally. And she's not much of a social butterfly. She's a big introvert. She doesn't have a lot of friends. The only friend that she has, she talks to online, and his nickname is Bolo929, I think it is. And they're constantly talking to one another, and they sort of develop feelings for one another. And it's just your usual like Cinderella story. It was cute. It was fun. I really enjoyed it. I gave it 3.5 stars. The next Cinderella type story I read was Right Text, Wrong Number by Natalie Decker. This one wasn't exactly a Cinderella story, but it had like the texting trope thing that I like, that I sort of associate with Cinderella type stories. So our main character is Layla, and she ends up texting somebody because she finds out that they have been messaging her boyfriend. So she messages them basically saying, you've ruined my relationship, like how could you do this, blah blah blah, because she obviously finds out that he's been sending pictures to her and she's been doing the same, and she just has like a massive blowout. But it turns out that she sent it to a wrong number, and this person that she is talking to, she actually hates in real life and he hates her, but they're talking to one another and they slowly develop feelings for one another. I didn't really like this one as much as I liked Hashtag The Real Cinderella, because I didn't like the characters in this at all. There was like maybe one or two characters that I really enjoyed, but the main characters were absolutely awful. Layla was a terrible person. Like, I did not like her in the slightest. She didn't even have really good character development. She had some, but it wasn't amazing. But yeah, it was okay. I gave it 3 stars. It wasn't bad. It was entertaining enough that I was able to finish it. But it's not one, because it's part of a series, it's not one that I'm actually going to continue on with the series either. I didn't like the characters, so they just seemed very, very shallow to me. But it was an alright read, but it was just kind of meh. And the last one that I read in January was the audiobook, and it was of course a Christina Loren book. As you know, if you've seen my previous videos, I had a month where I literally just binge read so many of Christina Loren's books, and I love listening to the audiobooks. They are fantastic. So I listened to Twice in a Blue Moon. This was a very, very different one to all the other ones I've read, and probably my least favorite of all the ones I have read. But it's, again, like a second chance type romance, and I have been in the mood for second chance type romances lately. I enjoyed it, but like I said, it was not my favorite. In this one, we follow Sam and Tate. Tate met Sam when she was 18 on a trip to London, and he basically became like her first love, her first everything. They only really spent time with one another over the course of 2 weeks. But in those 2 weeks, that was the most intense time of her life. She basically fell in love with him. And then he ends up betraying her because he goes to a publicist and kind of sells her out. So she confides in him that she is the lost daughter of this like famous actor. And this famous actor, everybody loves him, everybody adores him. When she's younger, she sort of disappears with her mother when her mother and him split up. And she's been living like a quiet life in a really small town with her mother and her grandmother. So she confides in Sam by telling him her story and telling him who her dad is. And he's just amazed because, like, you know, all the magazines are like, you know, where is this daughter? Like, where is Tate Jones? Where is she gone? What happened to her, sort of thing. So when he betrays her, she is forced to basically come out into the limelight and ends up being thrown into the world of acting, which was her dream, but it wasn't how she wanted to go about it. And then they come into each other's lives again 14 years later when Tate is filming a new movie that's probably going to be like the highlight of her career, and he is a screenwriter for said movie. So they come into each other's lives again and sort of trying to work out what on earth happened back then and why Sam did what he did. There wasn't a great deal of romance compared to other books, but it was okay. It was entertaining enough. I think I gave it 4 stars. No, I gave it 3.5 stars. But I enjoyed it. It was definitely my least favorite from the ones that I've read, but I still enjoyed it. It was okay. I enjoyed Tate as a character. I didn't like Sam too much, but you know. So yes, those are the books that I read in January. I think I would have to say that Stepsister was by far my favorite one, and the one I really expected to probably DNF. Like, I didn't think I was going to enjoy it as much as I did. So I really liked it. I think it was a good reading month. I read a nice little mix of books. But yeah, I think Stepsister definitely had to be my favorite. It was one of those books that I just could not put down. I really enjoyed it. But yeah, there we go, guys. I am going to wrap this up before the sun decides to disappear altogether. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!